As we get into the ideas of lead optimization, we need to talk about what a pharmacophore is. So we need to identify a pharmacophore. We also need to think about how we make structural changes and how that's going to lead us to a drug. Once we have selected our lead, we then have a challenge. We need to figure out, why does this lead bind to our target protein? What are the specific features in this lead that allow it to have the potency that it shows? This minimal feature set for binding is something called the pharmacophore of a lead. So on the left we have a lead, and this lead has some properties. You know, the alcohol or the carboxylic acid stand out. There's the alcohol, and then you have this nonpolar group. Well, as it turns out, you might analyze the structure and find out that all three of those features are vital for potency. And you might instead describe the pharmacophore with this sort of picture and saying, well, we need a nonpolar group over here, and this has to be some distance separated from a hydrogen bond donor and hydrogen bond acceptor, which the carboxylic acid gives us. And then over some distance away, we need a hydrogen bond acceptor, and that's our alcohol. And using this kind of picture, you might begin to select other compounds or make changes to our lead to get to our lead analog. So this lead analog preserves this nonpolar group. We have this amine at the top is a hydrogen bond acceptor through that nitrogen lone pair, and then we simply kept the carboxylic acid in place, and we use this fused benzene ring system to hold all three of those features together. So this became kind of the scaffold that holds everything together. As we make these connections between our chemical structure and biological activity, we are defining structure-activity relationships, or SAR, for our compound. Every drug program that tries to bind a target will establish the SAR of its lead molecule to its target. And you're just describing features. I need nonpolar groups here or hydrogen bond donors over there. This is an important step in the lead optimization process, understanding the SAR of your lead. Let's go back from the nitty-gritty of details and let's just see the big picture how this looks. So we're going to have some original lead compound, and we're going to make a lot of changes to this lead. We're going to try putting different groups in different places. Here's our original lead, and some of these changes are going to be good and some are bad. We'll just call them less optimized or more optimized. So we're talking about properties of our lead. And those properties could be potency, pharmacokinetics, or toxicity, metabolism, properties in a very general sense. As we make analogs of our lead, one of these hopefully will shine as being a really promising analog. Some are going to be bad, some are going to be good. The best one may define itself, say, this is a new lead. This is the second generation lead. We'll take that second generation lead, we'll make changes to it, and hopefully we'll have one or more compounds that are really even more promising, more optimized. That'll be our third generation lead. We will continue this process until we finally make a compound that is more optimized, in fact, optimized to the point that we feel that this lead could be potentially advanced into the clinic and tested in humans, that it may be safe and effective as a drug. We've now been introduced to the lead optimization process. We start with a lead. We then identify what its key features are and begin to understand the SAR around this molecule. Then modifications are sequentially performed on the molecule to improve its properties, hopefully getting us to a potential drug molecule.